Ты вон подойди, я тебя позвал, да чего это, я ох, да. Если ты душа, а ты он не тупо, ты говоришь, да, он тебе нахер, ты говоришь, что ты ахуханный, ахуханный, ахуханный.
We're here at the Oakland Coliseum, where every Sunday is Halloween, for this AFC matchup between the Chargers and the Raiders. When you look at this matchup, you've got to talk about the deep threats, the guys that can go long, and two of the best, speediest receivers in the game are going to be on the same field today.
Yeah, it's going to be fun to see how they, both teams, the offenses, how do they get the football to these speedy wide receivers, and no matter what you do on the defensive side, you go, well, we're going to take them out of the game. We're going to double team them. Really? How are you going to do that when they're in motion? They're always changing formations. Very tough to do now. You just got to rely on good tackling and try to prevent those short catches and long runs.
Darren McFadden lined up in the backfield. McFadden is going to secure the handoff. Nice chunk of yardage picked up by Darren McFadden.
When you talk about dynamic plays in the NFL, you talk about pass plays that are over 20 yards and running plays that are over 10. Well, that was a lot more than 10 yards. That is an explosive play for the offense at time.
First and 10. Heaving it down the field. And it's incomplete. Outstanding coverage on the deep throw, forcing the incompletion.
That's why he's one of the best in the league. He's aggressive. He can take away short passes, but also has the speed and the ability to get back there and knock down those deep ones too.
Failing to complete that one. So second down here. Halfback counter, going to be a tackle for a loss.
Well, the defense has got to be happy about this situation. Anytime early in the game you get an offense in third and long, you are looking to make a play and get things rolling on your side.
He'll go to the left. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
But this defense you're playing against, they're pretty good. So it's fourth down near midfield. Punt the football.
Fryers back in shotgun formation. Reaches out and grabs it. He is tackled at the 40-yard line.
I guess that's how we're going to be today, isn't it? We're just going to go for it on fourth down. That time they go for it and they get it. Good job.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. First and 10. Jones is taking the handoff. Touchdown.
Well, it was a wonderful run by the running back. No doubt about it. He gets the touchdown. Well, let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They blocked him up front, gave him that opportunity, and then he made it happen.
Well, this works out about 40% of the time if you look back on history, and they'll go for that two-point conversion. You talk about momentum. That turns into an eight-point trip, the touchdown and the two.
This offense and the head coach and the offensive coordinator, they're all aggressive. So, hey, well, it's not good enough just to get a touchdown. They want to get that extra point or 2 points. Nice job that time.
He steps out. Receivers stacked up on this play. First and 10. Eyeing that left side. He's got the grab, and he's got the first.
Good job by the quarterback that time. He doesn't panic. He reads that it's a zone, and he has to wait for the receivers to get in between the defenders. Nice throw and catch.
He'll fire it out to the left. That pass is incomplete.
Well, Jim, I can't say that's great defense. That's just a poor throw and a poor route run by the wide receiver.
Second down after the incompletion. Go. quarterback drops back, play action. The Chargers get a first down.
It's always good when your quarterback is able to deceive the defense with good play action fakes. That's what did it that time. Look at the quarterback. Nice fake. Defense reacts to the run, and now you throw it over the top for the easy completion.
First down and 10. Looking to the right side and throwing. That catch, good for a first down.
Quarterback that time realized it was zone coverage. He just waited for the defense to get out of position, and he threw it to the open hole.
It's a new era of football in San Diego with Mike McCoy, the man in charge, after Norv Turner had a long run there on the sidelines. And what about the Chargers this year?
Yeah, I think you said it right. It is a new era. What are they going to be? I don't think they'll be the same team we've seen in the past, where it's really all about the offense, throwing the football down the field, and it's all about Phillip Rivers. This will be a much more balanced approach to the football team, and I think it's going to work well.
The Chargers at the line of scrimmage, split backfield.
Here it's a second and 10.
He's looking to the right here on this throw.
I think this is one of the easier throws in the NFL. Don't make the mistake throwing it up the field. Throw it across the field so the receiver can run to it. That time the quarterback leads the receiver way too far on the post route.
The San Diego Chargers have asked Mike McCoy, right there. This is his first head coaching job in the NFL. They have asked him to come in here and turn around the fate of the San Diego Chargers.
Hey, Mike McCoy, let's see. Tim Tebow 1 year, Peyton Manning the next. How about that for a change? Now he has Phillip Rivers. It's going to be interesting to see how he changes Phillip Rivers and gets him back on track to one of the best quarterbacks in the NFL.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. They'll run it. Here's the handoff. Solid chunk of yardage picked up by Ryan Matthews.
Well, when you give up a running play that's long, you got to say this to the defense. You did not hustle enough. If you are hustling, when that running back makes that secondary move, you got to be there to make the tackle. Swarm the football, that's how you stop long runs.
This will be second down. McClain into the end zone for the touchdown.
The fullback gets the touchdown. So many things they do are underappreciated. Blocking for the running back, protecting the quarterback, but nothing like scoring a touchdown.
Lining up now for the two-point conversion. Rivers has got the football after the play fake. So they give up the touchdown, but they do not allow the two-point play.
Yeah, good job that time by the defense. So quick and so ready for that play. They reacted very fast. That's why they stopped it.
They'll take it at the 20. Offense lines up here. First and 10. And the give to Darren McFadden. Gains 12.
Good job that time by the running back. I'm sure he's a little winded after that play. He showed that speed getting out there and picking up those extra yards.
First down here after the run. Leading on that running attack again here on first down.
Well, the play is there to be made, but the offensive player doesn't get it done. Bad job on first down.
The Raiders come out in a bunch set. Fryer's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Looking for an interception by Eric Weddle. Nice tackle.
Good job that time by the defense.
I ain't got my niggas in the game, though. Fuck all that shit. the name Alexander and Dwight Freeman. You love me? Like, fuck that shit. They fucking back. And my hot dick tight like I'm Asian. Well, you're fucking welcome.
Not being fooled, being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did, they got the interception.
They come to the line and it's first down. Back the throw to the left. The Chargers now move the chains.
Well, I think we've heard this expression about 7,000 times. It's a passing league, so we all know that. So you got to be able to throw the football, pick up some first downs.
That reception gave them the first down. The marker. It comes out. That snap was not in time. It'll be a delay of game call.
Still first down.
After that penalty, it'll be first and 15. Fake. Scans the field. No one. Touchdown.
How about this get? The wide open receiver down the field. The quarterback, good job of finding. He throws it down there and he gets the easy touchdown.
And the extra point is good. Chargers getting set for the kickoff. Jacoby Ford with a chance to return one.
Well, a lot of good things happened on both sides of the football this time. How about that return by the return team? Good job, good blocking. Look at the speed of that guy running. They get the tackle from behind. They stop the touchdown.
Darren McFadden lined up in the backfield. He's brought to a halt.
Well, when you talk about edge players in the NFL, that means play on the edge, rush the quarterback, and stop the outside runs. How about that play by the defensive end?
Second and 10, and he hauls it in. The tackle is made.
Good job by the quarterback that time. Makes the decision. Throws it short. It does not get the first down, but I promise you, third and short is a lot easier than having third and long.
The Raiders need to get to the 19 to pick up a first down. And the fans here get more decked out in costume than any other site in the league. Overstock.com Coliseum, the home to the Raiders. Offense lines up here. The second quarter is underway with this snap. The pass is off the mark, and that's a three and out.
Good timing by the defensive player that time. He gets to the receiver just as the football is getting there and makes the hit, knocks that football loose.
Field goal try coming up by the Raiders. The kick is good.
Well, that time the offense had great field position. They don't take advantage of it, but at least they get 3 points. Good job by the kicker coming in and getting some points on the board.
The Chargers ready to return the kick.
Oh.
He's got a chance to return this one. Up in the slot. First and 10. Catch is made. In on the stop.
When you run the slant route, it's very important to know as a receiver that you're going to catch that football probably in between some linebackers.
They've got a first down now after that catch. Quarterback hands it off on the draw.
Good job of the defensive line standing in there fighting, and they hold the running back to a short game.
Second down coming up. And the carry to Ryan Matthews. They've got him down there. Royals lined up now as a slot receiver. Third and 7. Challenging the defenders to the right side.
When you talk about the play-action pass game, it's really when you call it. You got to be in a situation where the defense is thinking run, and when they are, do you have the courage, or I should say the smarts, to fake the run and throw the football? Good call that time by the offense.
And Matthews is lined up as the single back. Matthews.
Well, if you're a good running back, when there's not a lot there, you find a way to make some extra yards. Here in the red zone, it's even more important.
And here we have second down. Throws to the right. Touchdown!
What a tough throw and catch into a tight spot right there for the touchdown. But today's game, these players are so good that you have to throw it in traffic. They've got to make the catch. That time he did.
Lining up now for the two. He'll fire it out to the left. And they will not convert here on the two-point conversion. Good stand by the defense. Nick Novak ready for the kickoff.
You don't have to look at it.
Tackled right at about the 28-yard line. Nickel formation for the defense here. First and 10. And he's going to be brought down.
This defense is awesome. Blitzing. That time they blitz, they get the sack on the quarterback.
Man,
they time the snap
bro.
Count perfectly and catch the offense by surprise.
Yeah, man.
Roxon with that hit. And the ball's going to fall incomplete.
In these type of situations, when you lose the game, it's third and long. Don't try to be a hero, because when you try to be a hero, it's going to lead to a turnover. Then you really will be in trouble.
McFadden is lined up in a single back formation. The quarterback throws it on the mark.
Now there's nothing the defense can do. When you talk about a receiver like these guys out there now, and this one in particular, the double coverage, they're still able to go in between the defenders, rise up, and make the catch. Just stick the football on him. When you see a receiver run around like this, they're going to the corner, drive it, throw it on a line drive, so that way there can't be a mistake.
Darren McFadden lined up in the backfield. McFadden's handed the football. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
Well, when you try to tackle this guy, his legs are the size of a refrigerator, so hard to wrap him up. That's why he picked up the big game.
First and 10, going for the home run. He's in the clear.
Got to take advantage of situations like this. Not often in the NFL do you get somebody this wide open. Good job by the receiver. Nice job by the quarterback. Zaney, what do you get? It's a touchdown pass.
They're going to bypass the point after and try to pick up the two-point conversion. Would have taken the one-point gimme. They went for the two, and they are turned
you
away.
Fucking bitch.
Lining up here for the onside kick.
Wow, you think I'm not going to get it back? Watch this. Shoot. Come on now.
The receiving team has the recovery.
Maybe focus. It's fun, but it's pretty good. I'm not just getting in this with the fucking gate, bro. Because I'm the lowest level.
Offense lines up here. Now first and 10. Play action, looking to the right side and throwing. And incomplete.
That's a nice route that time by the wide receiver. Running the corner route, and the quarterback just throws it too far and misses it.
After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down. Rivers will take the snap from the gun. Trying to work that left side. Oh, that could have been intercepted, but he couldn't hold on.
This defense can pressure the quarterback. There's no doubt about it. They did this time, and it results in another incompletion.
And Gates is split out wide on the left. Halfway through the second, and ball's picked off. And brings the play to an end.
That was a terrible throw by the quarterback. When you're off target like that, you deserve to throw an interception.
Terrell Pryor will be under center. First and 10. Looking for a receiver on the left side here. Met at the 40-yard line.
Sometimes they tell the receiver just to go long, run a fly route, run a nine route, because that means straight ahead or a streak. Show the speed that you have and get it done.
There's some shifting around in the backfield. First and 10. On the run. He's got a wide open alley. Second down here. Trying to make something happen. Caught. He stacked up at that point.
That was good timing by the quarterback. He got out of the pocket just in time before he got sacked. And on that scramble, finds a guy down the field, makes a completed pass.
Ohio! On first down. He's looking to the right here on this throw.
Again, the defense gives up the first down that time inside the red zone. But there's only so many things the offense can do. Let's see if they can hold them.
First down, offense ready for the snap. Darren McBath will run with it.
Gain of two.
Hard to score a touchdown sometimes when you get in the red zone in the NFL. Why? Because the defense doesn't have to worry about passes down the field. The offense runs it. They are ready to get it done, and they do, and stop the offense for a short game.
Second and goal from the four. And a little screen set up here. Touchdown!
Good job that time by the offense. Scoring that touchdown and putting him ahead. And when you get ahead in a football game, the National Football League, it makes you relax and you play better.
He'll get set, looking to convert on this two-point try. looking for an open, and so they convert it here on the two-point drive. Raiders ready for action. Royals, a receiver in the slot. First and 10, and Matthews, his delayed start, now taken off on the draw play.
Boy, there's nothing like a draw play. It just catches the defense by surprise, and running backs, they love it because they know they have a chance to get some easy yards.
Rivers has got it in the gun. The defense gets a sack.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit here. You want to stop the offense from scoring here with under 2 minutes to go in the first half. Good pressure on the quarterback, and they take him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Two tight ends on the field here. Third and 12. Play action. Looks to his left. Incomplete, almost intercepted.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third's long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
The punter awaits the snap.
Not to fight anymore. This is one of those occasions. They're taking the knee. I like the call. Go in at halftime and just wait for the second half.
Hey, it's hot, bitch. Ohio!
Ohio!
Terrell Pryor will be under center. Looking to scramble, makes the catch in open space. The Raiders call a timeout here. They have zero timeouts remaining.
He did that whole shit. Guess what? You ain't gonna get that. All hell.
First down on the way. Running back in motion here. First and 10. Throwing now to his left. Nowhere else to go, and he's out of bounds.
What a nice corner route run by the wide receiver. He fakes the defensive back out, and look at the quarterback. He knows that little move. When he stuck it, he let him out to the corner. Nice throw, nice catch.
Ohio! Ohio!
First down here after the completion.
Sitting over the zone, he's in the zone, zone. He's putting it on zone, man,
The defense gets the sack.
That's an excellent job by the defense. Just gets quick penetration in there, hits the quarterback, and gets the sack. That clock keeps moving. What a job by the defense in this situation.
This will probably be the last play of the first half. Trying the right side. And they advance the ball onto the other side of the field. So that's going to do it for the first half. Raiders are up in this one. We're back here now in this one where the Raiders lead by 6. Time to check in quickly with Danielle Bellini from the sidelines. Danny?
I got a chance to quickly speak with Terrell Pryor during halftime. So far, his team is out in front, and he told me the important thing now is playing smart. If they can control play and just avoid costly mistakes, they'll be in good shape in the second half. That's all from down here, guys. Back to you.
Thanks, Danielle, and now we'll go to the field. It's first down as they head to the line. Phillip Rivers from the shotgun. Working that left side. Almost intercepted.
Watch it now, Barney.
Second down following that incompletion. Ryan Matthews takes the handoff, and he's tackled at the 30-yard line.
Power running. A lot of teams in this league don't even do it anymore. This team, they can power it up in there and pick up those tough yards.
Third down and two. And the give to Ryan Matthews.
I like this. Show some patience. Don't try to get it all in one play. Pick up first downs and try to go down the field and score.
Matthews lined up in the backfield. And Matthews is going to take the handoff now.
What a good job by the defensive player there, just flushing the running back and driving him into the ground.
That's second down coming up. They'll run it with him again. The tackle's going to be made, but he's beyond the first down marker.
Nothing like seeing a complete offense. That's what we're watching here today. Yes, we know they can throw it, but what they're showing us here, they can grind out some first downs running the football too.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. They'll stay on the ground on first down. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Anytime you see a defense that can't stop the runs right up the middle, there's a couple things. The middle linebacker's probably not doing his job, and you might not just have enough meat up inside to hold up against those big offensive linemen. Nice job that time. The run play gets the first down. You move those chains. Hey, it's kind of fun to watch a team tough enough and patient enough to run the football to get these first downs instead of throwing it all the time.
Set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground.
Woodhead's going to get it again here, and he's brought to the ground.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Play action fake, looking to throw. Tackled at the 13.
Good job getting the first down by the offense. A look at the defensive players on the sideline cheering there. Teammates on. Keep us on the sideline a little longer. That's what they're hoping for.
After the long game, let's see what they do here.
And they go draw.
This is where on the defensive side, where you have the lead, the team's driving against you, call something different so you can come up with a big play and stop the offense.
This has been a long drive so far.
They feed it to him again.
When you get down in the red zone, the offensive coordinator's got to call a play that deceives the defense. Let's see if he can do it. His team is down. He needs a big play here.
Challenging the defenders to the right side. Intercepted! They bring him to the turf. First down here. First and 10 to the ground here. He's brought down at the 20-yard line. McFadden's a running back normally, but this time lined up as a receiver in the slot. Second down and 10. McFadden's got the cool hands on a pass that had a lot of heat.
That's what you want to do. Get a first down while you're on top and keep that clock moving and just controlling the football game. Good job by the offense managing things so far here today.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion.
It's always good for the quarterback to really do a good job faking the pass right before the draw play. Get the defensive lineman up the field, get the linebackers dropping back for pass, and there's an open gap that the running back took advantage of. Second down and four.
He's wide open for the grab. Oakland, touchdown.
Well, there's an old saying in the NFL, you know how many points you need? And the answer is more. So no matter what the lead is, keep trying to score. Nice job by the offense getting that extra touchdown.
Oh, damn, man. Oh, yeah.
Well, this works out about 40% of the time if you look back on it. So from 2 yards out, they get it across and secure 2 extra points. Sebastian Janikowski lining up for the kickoff. Setting up return. And they tackle him down at the 37-yard line. Phillip Rivers has it under center. First down and 10. And the carry to Ryan Matthews.
Good run that time. It results in a first down, and it moves those chains on the sideline. Keep those chains moving. Fire that defense out.
Matthews. Brought down. Picks up the first as he's tackled at the 40.
That's a nice job blocking by the offensive line and a really good job by the running back. Seeing the proper hole. Gets up in there and picks up big yards. What a nice run by the running back. Picks up big yards, and he did everything that time. He picked the proper hole, gets through it, and shows that speed to get the long game.
We'll have one more play before the quarter expires. First and 10. Eyeing that left side. Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
Well, that looks like an upper body injury, Jim. I think we both can tell that. And now the question is, how bad is it? You just never know.
Going to get set in the slot for this snap. We are back for the start of the fourth quarter. Throws to the right. Two defenders there. Defended. Incomplete.
Well, these are the kind of throws in the NFL, Jim. You just take for granted that if it's open, you are going to hit it. But the quarterback makes a big mistake, leads the receiver too far to the inside, and it goes incomplete.
Failing to complete that one. So, second down here. Takes it from the eye. And a flag is down.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Boy, if his head got yanked back the other way, an obvious face mask penalty, and that's a big one.
It's about safety of the players, too. That's why when you grab, hit the helmet in certain situations, it's going to be a 15-yard penalty. Don't grab the face mask.
They face first down. Another carry here. Touchdown. And this game just got a whole lot more interesting.
You got to give the offensive line just a lot of credit. It's first and goal. They just line up and power the football in there. Nice run, but a great job by the O-line.
The Raiders ready to return the kickoff. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. First down coming up. Launching it deep. Clutch catch. He's brought down.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. No margin for error from just outside the goal line. Brings it in for the score in the end zone.
Well, the offensive line did it all on this drive, didn't they? Here it is on first and goal. Nice job of pass blocking. And the quarterback finds the open receiver for the touchdown.
Lining up now for the two-point conversion. So they get the touchdown. But they go for two and fail to convert.
I'll be the first to say it. That was a terrible decision to go for the 2 points. I'll give the defense some credit, but mainly the blame goes to the offensive play call.
The onside kick is turned away, and the receiving team has it. Royals in the slot. First and 10. Looking to the right side and throwing. That'll stop the play right there.
Find a way to score. That's always the mantra with every team when they get in the red zone. If you punch it in here, even though you're down by more than seven, it'll give you confidence for the rest of the game.
They're going to get him this time.
The offensive coordinator's just got to make some adjustments here. They can't stop the defensive line from sacking the quarterback, so either keep the tight end in or keep the halfback in to help block for the QB.
Detroit! Detroit!
Phillip Rivers has it under center. Second and 22. Play fake here. Wide open for the catch.
Well, even though they're down more than seven here, the offense down the red zone, it'll be good for them for the rest of this game. Their confidence for the offensive coach that they can punch this in for the touchdown.
Offense lines up here. Third down and six. He's looking to the right here on this throw. There's the offense picking up another first down on third down.
Nice throw that time by the quarterback in the red zone. Gets the completion. And there's some tight spots. Not a lot of room. So you got to really drive the football in there.
It's now second down. Touchdown. That'll close the gap.
Tight ends are more valuable when you get close to the goal line because they can use their body and push off and get open that way to score touchdowns. Nice job that time by the tight end.
Chargers getting set for the kickoff. We've got an injured player on the field.
That's a good job. He's able to get up and get off the field. And my guess is he's going to be okay. A little bit of a scare there, no doubt about it. That makes everybody nervous.
First and 10. McFadden. They go to the right side. Into the open now as he crosses the first down marker.
Good job by the running back that time, finding the open hole and picking up those extra yards.
So let me introduce you to the element, Here they come back to the line after the 50-yard gainer on the previous play. And it's Eric Weddle who makes the tackle.
Jim, the offensive coordinator, has done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. You're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
Here we go.
trying to beat the play clock. Jones got it on the handoff. He'll be brought down, but not before picking up the first down.
Good job by the offense getting the first down in the red zone. Now it becomes tricky. Can you deceive the defense or you get a chance to get a score?
The clock's really become a factor here, and the defense knows it has to get off the field as soon as possible to give the team a chance. 2 minutes to go in the second half. First down here after the run. Getting away from the pressure. Picks up about four.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they come up with a play that fools the defense.
Second down now. Second and goal from the five. They're setting up screen. A tackle behind the line.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
The quarterback is coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. Third and goal from the eight. He'll go left for a gain of about five.
Jim, the offense knows the situation. They know if they score, the game is over. They go over the few fundamentals. No penalties and hold on to the football.
Delay of game there after the quarterback did not get the snap in time.
Quarterback has a lot of jobs on the field. One of them is always watching the play clock. Make sure he avoids delay of games. 5 yards in the NFL, man, that's 5 yards you don't want to give up. When offense drives the ball, they always want to get something out of it, get some points. This time, the field goal kicker gets it done, he gives them three.
Tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. First down here. Gets away from the pressure. And they sack the quarterback.
You know, outside linebackers, they're everything all in one. They got to be a pass rusher, a pass cover guy, and they got to be able to stop the run. Nice job that time getting the sack.
Royals lined up in the slot. That's going to do it. The clock hits zero, and this game has come to an end. What a shootout it was, and what a great way to finish off the game with a victory like that.
Yeah, you know, I'm trying to figure out if it's a shootout or just a lot of really awful defense, but a lot of scoring, pretty exciting, and a good victory for the team.